When we have data, we want to be able to describe the type of information that we have. So with that, what we can do is describe the types of variables that we have. Now, variables are the characteristics that are being recorded or measured. So typically, they're about what is being surveyed. What are the questions that the researchers are asking? So we have this branch of all variables, but there's these two big branches, numerical versus categorical variables. Some other terminology, numerical is sometimes known as quantitative, and categorical is sometimes called qualitative. I'm going to stick to the terminology of numerical versus categorical, however those words might come up in other resources. Numerical is just as it sounds, that we collect our data, and when you look at your data, you see numbers. Typically, if you see numbers, it's going to be numerical. We'll talk about some special cases that would make it actually categorical. Categorical is typically words or images. The idea being that if you answer with words or pictures, you're creating these categories to fit into, or they're describing these specific qualities of our data. Then within each of these, there are some separate branches. Under numerical, there's these two branches of continuous versus discrete. Now, continuous data is typically a measured number. So, for example, like weight could be a continuous numerical variable. That's continuous because if I was collecting data on weight, maybe someone would answer like they're 125 pounds. But then maybe someone goes and gets their weight measured and they say I'm 187.21 pounds. We can get this accuracy with measured data that gives us decimal points, which means if we had a number line and we had these whole numbers on our number line, if it is continuous data, we can land absolutely anywhere on that number line. So 187.21, I could plot that at a very specific point. And 125, I could plot that at a specific point. But the idea is with this number line, we could have data landing anywhere. Discrete data is counted. So it's something you could count on your fingers and toes. So maybe what I could say is like the number of students in my classes. So in one class I have 24 students, in another class I have 30 students, in another class I have 36, but I'm not gonna see any decimal places here. These are being counted. So in terms of a number line for discrete data, if I have my whole numbers, I can only land at the whole number spots. I can't land in between two numbers. For categorical data, there's these three different categories. There's regular categorical, which really you can just call categorical. This could be words like yes, no, collecting information about weather. Maybe we say cloudy or sunny. So we have information in words, or you could have pictures. So cloudy versus sunny. Those would be regular categorical. Ordinal is a special case that creates categories, but they can look like numerical variables. So anything that could be ranked like first, second, third, that would be considered ordinal. Most rating systems, so say we were rating restaurants 1 to 5 stars, even though your data would be showing numbers 1 through 5, it's really fitting a category of it being the best restaurant or the worst restaurant. It's really describing something in words rather than a numerical value. And then the identifier is a special case. It's usually an ID number that's given by the researchers, or it could be something like your G number. So G123456, or just listed identifier numbers. It's not really a characteristic of the person or the thing that we're surveying, but it could be listed in the data and we'd call it an identifier. So these are our two branches. When we get into our descriptions, we're really just going to focus on identifying something as numerical versus categorical. But these branches can go further with these other descriptions. So what we're going to do is look at this data down here, and we're going to talk about our variables, the types of variables, and we're also going to talk about the cases. So the cases is describing the who of the study, who was surveyed. And it typically comes across as the rows of the data. And then the variables, like we talked about up above, is what was surveyed. What information did we collect? Which is typically going to come through as the columns of the data. So what we have here is information for 10 people. We collected information on gender, whether or not they smoke, if they could win an award, would they want an Olympic gold medal, Academy Award, or Nobel Peace Prize? How many hours per week do they exercise? How many hours per week do they watch TV? Their GPA, beats per minute, pulse, and then birth order, which means if they're firstborn, they're the eldest. And then there's this number 10 person who was the eighth born. So they have at least 7 siblings that are older than them. Maybe there's more, but this is birth order is giving us a first, second, fourth thingy there. So first let's talk about the cases. So the cases for this data, if we think about who was surveyed, and what we do is we look at the rows. And what we have here are 10 rows. So it means we talk to 10, in this case it's people. So our cases are these 10 people that we surveyed. The 10 people that were surveyed. If you can include sample size, this is a great spot to do it. If you have more information, you want to put that in there. I do remember this data coming from 10 statistics students. They didn't describe that here, so I wouldn't expect you guys to know that. But with that, if I had described something, I would say like the 10 statistics students in the survey or something like that. Then the variables. So up above, we talked about the types of variables, but if we want to know what the actual variables are, you look at the columns, which for the columns, you're going to have these titles here, and the titles are going to be our variables. So one variable was gender, another variable was whether or not they smoke, award, exercise, TV, GPA, pulse, and birth order. And the ID you can leave out. I leave it out because it's not an actual variable of the person. It's just something that was assigned to them. Maybe if it was something like G numbers, then I'd be more interested in it, but this looks like something just to organize the table. So leave it in, leave it out, either way is good. Then what we can do is describe these variables further with what type of variable are they. So what we can see for gender is they answered male, female, smoke was yes, no, and then for the awards, there were these 3 different categories that they could choose from. So those 3 variables right there are linking to categorical and even just regular categorical. That's where we're just seeing words in our data. So gender, smoke, and award, those are all categorical. If we're including ID, that's also categorical, and it's that special case of identifier. Then with the rest of our data, we see numbers. So we have this numerical information coming through. So we have exercise, TV, GPA, pulse, and then we're gonna hold off for 1 second with birth there. But with all of these is numeric values. If we wanted to describe continuous versus discrete, I mean, GPA, as soon as you see those decimals there, that comes across as continuous because it could land anywhere on a number line. That's because it's a calculated value, so it's measured. Pulse would probably be discrete because you're counting beats per minute, and it would be very difficult to count a fraction of a beat. And then exercise and TV is just kind of based on the person. With these numbers here, it looks discrete. However, if I ask someone how many hours per week do they exercise, and they actually like ran a clock and they said, I exercise for 5.27 hours, that is possible. So these exercise and TV have the potential to be continuous. Looks like they were answered in a discrete form. But those four right there are numerical. And then with birth order, these are numbers first, second, fourth. It's just giving them a category to fit into in terms of being the eldest sibling versus the second eldest versus fourth eldest. So it's not really describing a numerical characteristic, it's actually describing a category. So birth would be categorical, and that's that special case of ordinal. So when you see words, if you have words, those are going to be categorical. With the numerical, you just want to be careful of, are the numbers actually creating categories to fit into rather than an actual measurement or calculation?